Good evening, sir. So today our topic is melanoma skin cancer, which is our final year project topic, and we are going to give a presentation on that topic. And my teammates are Doipan Bhattacharya, Amrita Dev, Arindam Choudhury, and myself, Kamala Chakraborty. So Doipan, start.
So good evening, sir. The final year project we have, that is melanoma. The skin cancer, which is frequent, most frequently diagnosed disease in the world, it is very deadly. And according to a report in Morocco, skin cancer is a health major problem requiring a comprehensive policy of care. The situation is so disturbing that approximately 30,000 new cases of melanoma per year. So there are 7.2% of all deaths in Morocco. So this is so much of so much we need to very much taken care of this thing very seriously, because what happens nowadays, pollution is very common thing. So the rise of pollution makes this kind of disease happen. So main reason is the depletion of the ozone layer, and therefore the rays of the ultraviolet rays the sun have, and this kind of rays when getting into our atmosphere and making our habitat a dangerous place. So let's just skin cancer, what is a cancer? Is nothing but a basically an abnormal growth of skin cell. Suppose it is the DNA sequence when it got manipulated by something, some sequencing problem that have faced, then some cell got created. That cell have some malfunction. Suppose we have a computer. So what happens when we have any virus on it or any malware? What does a malware basically do in our computer system? It just basically spread its ways to our system and manipulate the day-to-day work. So cancer is basically a malware which is getting installed in our body systems, which is a very unfortunate, but this is the basic what a cancer does, what is a cancer. So there are major three types of skin cancer. One is basal cell carcinoma, and is squamous cell carcinoma, and melanoma. This is the three basic type of skin cancer, and here we just talking about the melanoma. This is a diagram that is we have an image, input image. There is a we reduce the average, the synopsis from that image, and we process that, and then we have based to the processing we make the decision whether it is melanoma or something else.
So basically melanoma is the most deadliest skin cancer, one of the most deadliest skin cancer that ever exists, and if we don't skin cancer is one of the most deadliest and dangerous cancer that have ever caught in our body, and if it is not treated early, then it can be also life taking, there is a life risk that's there in this cancer. So basically the sunburned places have the most chance to have cancer, and this type of melanoma skin cancer, and basically this melanoma skin cancer originates from the melanocytes of our epidermis, which is present in on our skin. And basically there is some rules or some set of mnemonics through which we can identify whether it's a skin cancer or melanoma skin cancer or not. That is asymmetry, border, color, diameter, and evolving. So asymmetry is the affected area of the skin. Is it irregular or not? Irregular or not symmetrical, that we have to look after. So first, if that is a melanoma skin cancer, so that places it, that the affected area is irregular, and bordered, the edges of that particular affected area on skin is very difficult to define, and that is not any proper place, that is, I mean, abstractly distributed over the skin. And color, the color can be different. It is not a particular color on the affected area, and diameter is absolutely greater than 6 millimeter. It is minimum, and evolving the this shape, the color and the size is changing, and that is a completely that start increasing and that start affecting through our body, and it can be deadliest. So first, what is the main reason that we are developing a model for melanoma skin cancer? Basically, doctor, if you go to a doctor and they will first go for test, and they will, it takes a lot of time. They will test you and a report will come. So this is a very, you know, a long time or long time to have a report and detect it. So basically, we are creating, or we are doing as an engineer. So we will try to make something that will save the time, and that always be convenient for the people. So we are trying to make a model through which you can detect whether it is a melanoma skin cancer or not. And this is the way, and this is the easiest way that people can have the reports, whether it is skin cancer or not, in the fastest way, and time will be saved, so they can start their treatment early. So this is the basic thing. And of course, there is some set of predefined rules on basically those who have most of the chances to have this type of cancer. That is basically risk factors are there. Suppose someone has very fair skin. So fair skin means less melanin in skin. So that type of skin has melanocytes, skin in melanin, that creates melanin creating skin, cells, that is very less in skin. That means that type of skin has a huge chance to have skin cancer. Exposed sunburn, as we know that in this nowadays pollution and this type of cases, when we are our exposed area, sunburned area especially, can have skin cancer due to the UV ray of sunlight. And there is many people in this world that have moles, and that is, we just avoid it as a butt mole or like that, but that moles can also be a harmful and deadliest and life-taking. So prevention is basically how to prevent it. Basically, if you want to prevent skin cancer, melanoma, first you have to avoid the sun, and you have to wear some full sleeves and something that is not the areas particularly that is not affected by the sun. Basically, the lips, hand, palm and genital area, this type of places are basically attacked by skin cancer, melanoma skin cancer. And we have to, at the middle of the day, basically from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. through an examination or through a test, the scientists prove that that 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. that time sunlight contain highest UV light. Ultraviolet rays. So that particularly that time we should avoid wearing exposed or some sleeveless dress like that, and that can be sunburned by the sunlight. And we have to use sunscreen around when we are stepping out from our home, and we have to wear protective clothing. And nowadays also some fairness cream, tanning face pack to remove the tan, these type of things we have to very particular and sure about it before using that. So these are the basic thing that we have to take care of before. This is just a prevention that to avoid the skin cancer, melanoma skin cancer. So this is the basic project model. Now our teammate Dwipan Bhattacharya is just going to talk about the project, our model, that much how we did it, and the technical stack and the technical details about the project. Dwipan, start.
Though we have not finalized the libraries that we are going to use in this project, although we are using the Python, but the libraries are still now not fixed, because I have just trying to getting some insights from the projects that have been created earlier in this concept, and I have found there are a data set which have around 33,000 images. I can show the image data set that I have. Here I have that image data set. this is the image data says it is totally 33,000 image I have, and I have to train the data set according to the this, and this I have downloaded from Kaggle, the ISIC melanoma. From here I have downloaded this. Melanoma classification. So this data set, this chip images I have downloaded. So this images I have thought of that I will be trained it through a Python, basically OpenCV, and I will use PyTorch or TensorFlow, and I am trying a model which is there in the online. But the problem is that with me is the model is taking longer time than usual. In my system got stuck in that, and it is like a disaster to train like this kind of images. Though I am trying to improve these things, so here the project totally current status of the project, I am trying to figure it out that how can I manage those data to train the model and make necessary tweaks to get a proper prediction from the model and necessary details that should be extracted from the data or analysis. So this is the technology or the data set we are going to use in brief.
Very good. Amrita, are you saying something, or you are okay? Next time you will be. Okay, very good. After slow start, you have covered, actually have come to a project, but stick to it. No issue about the selection of model, but you have selected this thing. Another thing, I think this skin cancer is a very random event. It can happen any time of age, so it is random event, and it should be aware of it. That is one of the issue of this project, so that whenever you are doing project, you are also aware of this common phenomena which can happen to anybody anytime. Whenever you have found it, the COVID situation, that you cannot appoint a doctor very soon. So whatever we are hoping to, that we probably can able to make an Android app so that people before going to doctor or they can perform the usual diagnostics, or if maybe general MBBS people, they can also refer. So I will also request Amrita, because her mother can have access if you get some information from any health persons. So then approach to others. So very good presentation. So after your final year exam, then another 1 week or 2 weeks, I think you can do it. You can find the collab. Sir. Yeah.
Whatever Doipan has said, actually the data set is very big, and so it is very difficult for Doipan to total data set to be run.
Sir, we don't have that type of system that we can support that 30,000 images, and we can compile it properly and get a proper output. We can show that. We don't have that much good system.
No, we have done the similar kind of scenario in our brain tumor also. This same, more than this, we have done through the Scolab. Okay, you can take the help of Scolab, and I have generally any Gmail have 15 GB capacity. I have already have a Gmail with 100 GB. This is a purchased Gmail personally by me. So whenever you are ready after exam, then you can take that particular Gmail and password. You can take 100 GB of data and 12 hours free in Colab. You can try. That's it, because any other resources our college doesn't have, and it is very difficult for you to approach ISI. I don't know whether they are, ISI have facility, but whether they will give it to us, I don't know. But we can always try. Calcutta University, we can try. Whatever I know, only IIT Kharagpur might have. So Colab is okay. Our students have already done this Colab, and they have made a approval. We have already written a paper on Colab and this is data set. So data set will not be a problem actually, but definitely if you have a GPU, that will be better. Okay. So any more issues? Thank you.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So right now, what is your idea? I think within a quick 2-3 days to find a model. But I always suggest you go for PyTorch, because we have already raised resources for PyTorch, because Praveen Kumar, Saibi, all these they have done in PyTorch. And PyTorch also, industry recommendation is PyTorch is better than TensorFlow 2. So PyTorch, you can focus, and Google Colab, you can focus. Let's see, because it can be done. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Very good presentation. Very good. Thank you.
Sir, yeah, tell me. If you give some time, so I would request to Dwipan to give a small brief description about the model.
Yeah.
So
sure, there sure.
Are, in our report, there is a few flowchart of our project. So I would request to Dwipan to briefly describe the flowchart of the model. Yeah, that is the very small flowchart of this model, and Dwipan, please elaborate the brief description so that it will be clear for all of us.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, okay. Yes, you are audible.
So basically, I have go through the resources that I have, and I found that this kind of flowcharts are to break the problem into the small problem, so I can assimilate all the things and exactly solve the problem that I want to solve. So the first thing that is I11 urination correction, that's I have got from where the image should be corrected, and particularly the lights and the other things that should be corrected from the source image that I have. And also we have tweaking the image to get the different angles of the image to train the data set, and then we generate the mask, then it perform from the Gaussian filter, and then it going to the layer that is from where the real programs come to an action. It is all there from here, the Gaussian filter, all the things we have done to clear the data or make the image fit for our model. Then we go to this layer, and this layer is this 5 layers of system that we're going to build. And by these five layers, when you pass the images, at the end of this, it will say us that the image is benign or melanoma. That is, the every layer has its own benefit or own task, and in every layer we are getting more closer to what is the actual scenario according to the picture. But the detailed work according to these layers are still pending, so we are working on that. And till now we have just explored that this is the way to design a learning model, and that's why we have taken this and make this and add this here.
Good. Whatever found, everything is good, but next time better it is show by the PPT PowerPoint, because from the document it is difficult, and your writing should be left and right both justified, that you have please do, and font size make it 14. Okay, I think you might make a font size maybe 12, try to make it 14 and both side, otherwise document is excellent. And presentation mode, you try to get the PPT out of it, that will be more because it is, this whole presentation will be in YouTube, and you will be proud that next time whenever after 1 year or 2 year, 3 year, you'd like it to view as a YouTube, that how we present it. Sir, but really good work, any very good work. So start.
Sir, yes sir. So I'm saying that, do we need to develop Android app before after the our 7th SEM, after before the 8th SEM, I mean the final SEM, and we have to submit with with our main project, we have to submit the app also. Before that, we have to develop Android app also. That's some I want to confirm.
No, no, there is no such issues. Don't take it in your head, because you try to do this. Whenever you make an Android app, that app will not be popular immediately. So better we make our foundation to be very strong.
Yes, sir.
So this thing should be not only strong, and it should be published in a paper. Then our objective should be paper. And the app development may be done by you. We'll target it. Maybe basic app we should definitely should target by you, and maybe other juniors I can drop it.
Yes.
But basic foundation, so that whatever we can do, but whatever
you have said. It means the Android app is the extension of the project, right? That is not immediately mandatory.
Absolutely. Not at all. This seventh semester, not at all. I am saying that the eighth semester, okay, we should try.
Sir.
But our basic thing is that whatever we are developing, that should be, because this is a standard model of deep learning.
Yes.
Whatever, this is the standard thing, this max pooling. If you go to convolutional neural network, everywhere the max pooling. But how you select your max pooling setups and all this tune, that you have to, that is different from one kind of problem to another kind of problem. Because it is this melanoma detection also, you can detect for any patch on the faces of you, because of us. So we can detect the same program with some little modification. We can detect for any abnormalities of skin.
Okay, sir.
We should focus on it, and app development should be later. And maybe your team must be there, but maybe a different subsequent junior. But app should be targeted. That is, I don't want to.
Yeah.
But the basic things, anyway, app, there are thousands of apps are there. But which app is people are used? So better we make a paper presentation, then your name should be there, that your name, my name will be there. So we should, and in paper, you cannot say, I have developed an app. Paper, you say, I have, these are the models, and here my model give this ratio, so then your paper will be chance, will be published, even in local Indian paper. Okay.
Okay.
So okay, right, sir. Now, I think you every should focus on your view. Also, we are after your final day, after your seventh semester, you have this project should continue. We do not have any different projects. We should continue this project. Okay. Okay. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you.